Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Surah Al-Baqarah. This is a Madani surah consisting of 286 verses. It is divided into four main sections. The first section is an introduction. This section mainly covers about the characteristics of three groups of people, the creation of Adam alayhi salam, and his appointment as Khalifa on the earth. In the second section, Allah describes Bani Israel's mistakes and arrogant behavior and their deposition from the status of the chosen nation. In the third section, Allah confers the status of the chosen nation to the Muslims and appointed them as a middle nation, which is Ummat-e-Wasat. The commandments and guidelines are given to the Muslims to keep the chosen status. The fourth section is conclusion, where Allah reminds us of His might, summarizes the articles of faith, and teaches us the prayer for grace. In this clip, we will cover some key contents of section 1 and section 2. The surah begins with the letters Alif Lam Mim, called Harfa Muqatta'at. Its exact meaning is known only to Allah. There is no doubt in this book and is a guide for those who are mindful of Allah. Three groups of people are mentioned. The first groups are believers who believe in the unseen, establish prayer, give zakat, believe in this revelation, and have sure faith in the hereafter. The second group are disbelievers who persist on their disbelief and do not listen to the message. The third group are hypocrites who keep two faces and spread corruption on the earth. The disbelievers are challenged to produce a surah like the Quran, but they could not do it. We cannot deny Allah, as He brought us to life when we were lifeless, and He will cause us to die and He will resurrect us. Allah created Adam alayhi salam and honored him by making him the successor on earth. Allah taught Adam alayhi salam the knowledge of the world. On the commandment of Allah, all angels prostrated to Adam alayhi salam except Iblis, who refused and acted arrogantly, and he became the outcast. Adam alayhi salam fell to the temptation of Iblis and ate the prohibited fruit in paradise. Adam alayhi salam repented immediately and Allah forgave him. Allah sent everyone to the earth and said, whoever follows the messages from him will be successful. The lesson, we should be among the first group of people and adopt those qualities. We should learn from Adam alayhi salam's attitude of humility. In the next section, Allah addresses Bani Israel. He highlighted the favors He bestowed upon them and their arrogant and rebellious attitude. Some of Allah's favors, they were honored above others, saved from persecution, parted sea for them, forgave after they worshipped the calf, revealed the Torah, provided food, shade, and water. Bani Israel showed extreme arrogance and disobedience when Allah commanded them to sacrifice a cow. Allah took a covenant from them to worship Him alone, be kind to parents, relatives, orphans, and the needy, speak kindly to people, establish prayer, and pay zakat. They broke the covenant of Allah, except a few among them. With the story of Harut and Marut, who were two angels sent by Allah as a test who used to teach magic, Allah highlighted Bani Israel's attachment to magic. Allah says He despises magicians. Allah says, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah gives example of Ibrahim alayhi salam. When Ibrahim alayhi salam was asked to submit, he immediately submitted to him. Allah appointed Ibrahim alayhi salam as a role model for the people. While raising the foundation of the Kaaba, Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail alayhi salam made a supplication to raise a messenger, which is Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam, among the people of Makkah, who will recite the ayahs, teach them the book, wisdom, and purify them. All messengers submitted to one God, and they advised the same to their children. Every person will be rewarded for what they earn, and they will not be asked about others. Lesson: Allah narrated the crimes and mistakes of Bani Israel to warn Muslims not to indulge in those mistakes. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.